The COVID-19 pandemic, also known as the 2019 novel coronavirus, began as an epidemic in China before rapidly spreading across the globe in a matter of months.
COVID-19 has since spread to nearly every country in the world. The U.S. is now the worst hit, followed closely by several European nations.
This led the World Health Organization to classify it as a pandemic.
Describing the situation as a pandemic does not change WHO's assessment of the threat posed by the virus. It doesn't change what WHO is doing, and it doesn't change what countries should do.
Many pandemics have spread to humans from our close proximity with animals. These are known as zoonotic infections, or diseases that can spread from animals to humans. Experts believe that the coronavirus is zoonotic, originating from wild animal meat sold at the Wuhan seafood wholesale market in Wuhan, China. According to the CDC, 75% of emerging infectious diseases in people are spread from animals. There were three influenza pandemics in the 20th century, all of which have been linked to animal origins. The Spanish flu of 1918 infected 500 million people, a quarter of the global population at the time, between January 1918 and December 1920.
Perhaps until recently, Spanish flu has been what some people call a forgotten pandemic. But it was a huge global calamity.
The death toll is estimated to be between 50 million and 100 million, making it the deadliest pandemic in recorded history. The exact origin of the virus has not been pinpointed. Epidemiological data indicates that the pandemic may have begun in the U.S. in March 1918, at a crowded army camp in Fort Riley, Kansas.
He had a fever, sore throat, headache, nothing serious. 1 minute later, another soldier showed up. By noon, the hospital had over 100 cases. In a week, 500.
Lauren Miner noticed a population that he was servicing, was getting sick, and very sick, with an influenza unlike any he had ever seen before. He considered it so serious, he felt the need to alert the U.S. Public Health Service to this.
Another theory is that it started in a British base camp at Etaples in northern France in the winter of 1917. Experts believe that the live pigs and nearby live geese, duck, and chicken markets may be linked to the virus's spread through the overcrowded camp. A 2014 study from the University of Arizona in Tucson found that the virus likely originated from poultry. Previous studies have revealed that it likely circulated around humans and pigs for at least 2 to 15 years before becoming a lethal virus. The flu pandemic of 1957, aka the Asian flu, first emerged in East Asia in 1957.
One of the upper respiratory infections, something like a cold, only it's caused by a flu virus. And the difference between the Asian influenza and the influenza that we've been having all of these past few years is that this strain began in Hong Kong and spread from Hong Kong to the rest of the world, including the United States.
It's estimated that the virus killed 1.1 million people worldwide. The exact origin is unknown, but some experts believe it may have been transmitted to humans from wild ducks or poultry. The 1968 flu pandemic was first recorded in Hong Kong in July 1968. The virus killed an estimated 1 million people worldwide. This was the first known outbreak of H3N2, a viral strain that can infect humans, poultry, and pigs. Researchers isolated H3N2 in U.S. turkey and swine farms and found that some strains of the virus can be transmitted from turkeys to pigs and then to humans. The virus that caused the Spanish flu pandemic, Influenza A virus subtype H1N1, emerged as a different strain in the 21st century, swine flu. The swine flu pandemic lasted between January 2009 to August 2010.
Influenza pandemics, whether moderate or severe, are remarkable events because of the almost universal susceptibility of the world's population to infection.
WHO raised its pandemic alert from phase 4 to phase 5 due to the increasing human-to-human spread,
infecting between 700 million to 1.4 billion people across the globe. The World Health Organization confirmed 18,036 swine flu-related deaths worldwide, but between 151,700 and 575,400 people died from the virus. According to the CDC, researchers found that the genetic makeup of H1N1 combines an assortment of five different types of influenza: North American swine influenza, North American avian influenza, human influenza, and two swine influenza viruses from Eurasia. Concentrated animal feeding operations, or CAFOs, are a possible origin of H1N1.
This is the most concerning emergence of a novel flu virus in 40 years.
Thought to have originated in Mexico, experts say that at some point, someone came into contact with an infected pig at a farm, during transportation, or at the slaughterhouse.
According to Gregory Gray, an infectious disease epidemiologist at Duke University, when respiratory viruses get into these confinement facilities, they have continual opportunity to replicate, mutate, reassort, and recombine into novel strains. While these viruses can run quickly through human populations and then burn out, in CAFOs, viruses have a greater potential to spread due to the continual introduction of new animals. Viruses can then infect factory farm workers. Though not a pandemic, the severe acute respiratory syndrome, aka SARS virus, has animal origins as well.
The doctors' union recommending drastic moves to deal with the epidemic. They say all businesses should be shut down for a fortnight to stop the infection spreading from person to person in the workplace.
The 2002 to 2004 outbreak infected 8,098 people and killed 774. In 2017, scientists from the Wuhan Institute of Virology in China traced SARS to horseshoe bats in the Yunnan province. Civets, a nocturnal animal native to tropical Asia and Africa, acted as an intermediary between the virus, bats, and humans. It was likely passed on to humans through civets sold at meat markets in China. In the wake of the coronavirus, China banned the sale and consumption of wild animal meat.
Wild animal wet markets have long been recognized as a major pandemic threat. As coronavirus spread, China announced it would crack down on them.
There has been a growing concern among people over the consumption of wild animals and the hidden dangers it brings to public health security since the novel coronavirus disease, COVID-19, outbreak. Zhang Taiwei, a spokesman for the top legislature's Legislative Affairs Commission, said in a statement, but wild animal markets aren't the only concern. New viruses come from factory farms as well. According to Gray, new strains of coronavirus have the potential to come from swine CAFOs due to the fact that humans and pigs share similar immune systems. He believes that identifying new viruses in CAFOs should be a priority. Diseases derived from animal agriculture can even affect produce. Leafy greens such as spinach, lettuce, and fresh herbs are some of the vegetables most frequently linked to bacterial infections. According to the Food Safety Project, there were 713 produce-related outbreaks associated with foodborne disease between 1995 and 2005. The main causes of these bacterial outbreaks prior to harvesting are linked to animal agriculture. Soil acts as a reservoir for pathogens due to the addition of animal waste. Following a 2006 E. coli outbreak, the CDC, FDA, and officials from California traced the infection's origins back to contaminated spinach. Investigations linked the contaminated spinach samples to cattle manure and pig feces from a California ranch. Water contaminated by farm animal waste may have also caused the infection. A 2018 outbreak was also linked to animal agriculture. The FDA believes that manure from a cattle feedlot in Yuma, Arizona, one of the largest lettuce-growing regions in the country, was likely washed into a nearby irrigation ditch, and water then carried the contaminated waste to vegetable fields.
Lettuce grown in Yuma is being blamed for an outbreak of E. coli across the United States. The CDC says there have been 35 cases in 11 states linked to it.
Dust from the feedlot may have also caused the outbreak. Lettuce farmers believe that their fields need to be located further away from cattle feedlots, while others have discussed buying the feedlot, which houses 100,000 cows, and shutting it down to prevent further outbreaks. Like coronavirus and SARS, some other diseases spread from humans to animals, such as bovine spongiform encephalopathy, better known as mad cow disease. in the 1980s and again in the 2000s. Mad cow disease, known as Creutzfeldt-Jakob's disease in humans, made headlines. While not contagious through person-to-person contact, the fatal degenerative brain disease was linked to cattle that were fed sheep remains infected by scrapie. While humans have always been affected by viruses, pandemics began when humans started living in close proximity to animals. This made it easier for diseases to jump from animals to humans. In the 2006 bird flu, a virus of our own hatching, Dr. Michael Greger wrote, "If you actually want to create global pandemics, then build factory farms." In a speech for the UW School of Medicine and Public Health, he said,
"There has never been a single recorded emergence of a highly pathogenic flu virus in chickens kept outdoors. Never once has a dangerous, deadly flu virus ever seemed to have arisen, that we know of, in an outdoor chicken flock. Now, I mean, you can breed the deadly virus here. It can escape and infect backyard birds, free-ranging flocks, even wild birds. But that transformation from harmless to deadly always seems to happen in these kind of conditions."
As long as humans continue to eat meat, we run the risk of coming into contact with new zoonotic diseases. But a shift away from animal agriculture and wild animal meat toward a new, plant-based food system could help create a safer, healthier, and kinder world. That's it for today. What are your thoughts on pandemics? Do you think they're related to animal agriculture? Let us know in the comments below. As always, remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell. New videos every Tuesday and Friday.